Hey guys, I want to do a layout, but this one I cut the door. It's kind of burnt, huh, guys? That's my mistake, you know. I thought that, you know, save money buying cheap wood can sell stuff, but this wood not that great. I burn every time I cut, so I'm going to use this for my layout. So if you buy this for me, it's not gonna be this material, so you guys can see the grain there. I don't know if you guys want this like this, just let me know, guys. I have a ton of them. Like, I bought like 4 sheets, big one. I spent like a lot. I just wasted the money, guys, I'm telling you. But if you want the one is better than this, it's kind of only okay guys, I'm back. So I just let you guys compare this one. See, you barely see the wood grain, but this one you can see the wood grain there, guys. So this one is so cheap. When I cut it, it's not cut through because it curl. It have to be flat, so in order to cut straight through, if not cut straight through, will burn, guys. So let me know, guys, if you guys want this one. It's kind of, see that kind of curl, not really straight, and it's burn every time. It's really weak, not that good quality. But the one I have been using, it this one is really good wood. It's expensive to why it is cost. So to let you guys know, when you're gonna buy this one, is this one I said use for my layout, but I'm selling, not gonna sell this. Meaning I'm gonna cut the better wood for you ladies, okay? If you guys like the wood grain, it's let me know, guys, I can sell it, but I not recommend it because it's really weak. I did worry when I chip this, I'm gonna break it, guys. Okay. Now I'm gonna do so this one I saw Eileen Tan, she used, I'm not sure she used the wood or she bought I suspect it's a wood from, so I didn't really know how she do the technique or did, because she didn't tell. So sometimes it frustrated me how some, you know, when you want to see somehow some lady do this and that, but there's no tutorial how to figure it out. Anyway, so I kinda try do my own way, guys. So I'm gonna use this door, and I'm gonna use Lindy's stamp gang here. I'm going to use the dark chocolate 2-3 here. I need to order more Lindy's stamp gang. I haven't a lot of these, guys. So I'm going to use this one, the dopper here. See, guys, I'm trying to do really slow as possible my tutorial so you guys can get it what I'm doing. And another hand, if the black is good, the smoke from burn, so it's kind of like, check how I get the antique, don't you guys think? So I'm gonna use the same color. I'm going to use different color. This one is what, cocoa bean copper. I'm not sure that I want to use that one. On the dopper that I have, only white one there, and this one. I'm gonna do this. I think I'm going to spray with this one, is a Mission Bell's brow here. I'm gonna try this one. I believe so. Yep. I'm gonna try it. It's the Buccaneer Bebu. Never pronounce it right, guys. If not, sorry about that. I should clean my mat first so I get the acrylic in on my door. Oh, you know what? I'm going to add another color before I dry it up. I'm going to use this one, Wendy Sophia there. But great, no, I don't want that. I'm going to use this, the Gossamer Gold. This one. Use so many color, guys. Okay, now I'm going to paint in acrylic paint, guys. You can use gesso too if you want, guys. I'm going to use this white acrylic paint. I paint this 3 or 4 times. I coat it, 3 or 4 times. Maybe this kind of this one get bubble look. I try to paint like really, thin coat if possible. But as I told you, ladies, I kind of really heavy handed to get like bubble look all the time, guys. So I'm going to use this Distressed Crackle paint from Tim Ho here. So I'm going to make it crackle look, okay. I'm not sure you guys can see this one is the cracker and look like this one it, the paint is falling off, guys. I'm not sure you guys can tell, guys. I did love how it turned out the first time I did this guy. Well, I made couple time of the crackle effect, but not really crackle, but this one it look like not sure you can see it like peeling off there, guys. What I'm going to do, I'm gonna use the Tim Hortons 2 here, that it you can scratch up the paint off, guys. Look like the paint is like a peel off, guys. You guys can see it, no. So it's kind of scratch off some paint, guys. Not sure you guys can tell or not. See here. Sure you guys can see it. You guys can see it now. I'm not really sure, but you guys can check out the photo on my blog, guys. To do this so I kind of love it how it turned out. I'm going to use Tim Hortons the one test photo in here to distort all the edges. Okay guys, to get like antique look, hopefully when test looking. Speed up. Here guys, what do you guys think? Maybe I'm gonna use my keyhole here, this one. It is cut from the chipboard, so I'm going to use dab this one there. Wow. I did paint with all of these, but I forgot about this guy. Maybe I should dab all the color again. Actually, I like it dab because it show up. Pop up the crackle effect, guys. first time trying it, guys. Oh, you guys think I love it, guys. Look at that. I'm gonna use this spray again, Mission Bell's brow here. You know, I should order more in this stamp gang spray though, guys. I love. You know what? I'm going to use some some of this guy. I haven't used this one yet, guys. So I'm going to use this one. It's the Moonshadow ink here, Emerald. So let's see how this one turn out, guys. I'm just playing around here, guys. So I haven't remember what color I used all this guy. But I love these guys. My crackle effect is pop up a lot. So I hit my ink and drip up and will dry with my heat too. I think it rusty enough. No, guys, this is what it look like, my door. I'm going to just do it on the Tim Hortons again, guys. See, this is my door. I can see it. I kind of do love how it turned out. Whoa. I'm not sure if I do a whitewash or what gonna happen. I'm not really sure. But this is my keyhole here. I'm gonna use that one right there. This one is not going to use the ink there. I'm going to use hammer. Guys, it's for the door. I use my hot glue. See that guy? Now, if I coat with the wire polycan again, I'm not really sure how it turned out, guys. I'm gonna use a little bit. Of this wire curly pin, and we'll do a little bit of water. This one is dropping alcohol, guys. I'm not really sure how it is turn out. Is this kind of shiny or like glossy, guys? I'm gonna use this for whitewash, guys. So and wipe it off. So you get that color look, guys. What do you guys think? See the door, guys, not too shiny. What do you guys think? You guys like it? I kind of like it, ladies. So this one ready for my layout. So this gonna be a separate video then. So this how I paint this door, guys. So now you guys can see how I made it. So it's kind of my first time doing it, guys. So I just paint, you know, just playing around, not really sure what I was doing, you know. Well, I know what I want to make, like a crackers effects, and pretty much that it, but I'm not sure what kind of cracker I will get. I never get any good at making cracker, you know, effects at all, guys. So that's it, my tutorial for this, how I make this door, guys. Okay, you guys can check out for my photo of this door, so you guys can see the closer look how this one. I just love it, guys. I just love so much, guys. Thank you, lady, for keep watching my door. I'll see you guys later when I use this for my layout. Okay, guys, thank you, lady.